her beauty. Load it up. Now they're gonna get it out of there with all those tables. Here we go to Abaco. See you there.
I don't want to say shantytown, because like you think of shantytown and you're like really crappy houses put together with like CGI, and right. These were like legit houses with like bricks, and they had roofs and doors and windows and all of that. It was just all quite compact.
Right.
So it was a huge Haitian community, obviously from the earthquake, and they just, like when the storm surge came through, they just got displaced. This is what's left on the left hand side.
Apparently
it's a pretty lively place. And if like out there, you can actually still see some foundations of houses.
Right.
So like just there. And you can, like, if you walk out and you, like, you can see the different floor patterns. So you can be like, oh, well, this is where the kitchen was, this is the toilet, the bathroom. Some of the toilets, the ceramics are still in place. But the government here is having a huge operation cleaning it up.
They just don't, they don't have anywhere to put everything.
They're just dozing it. They got a landfill.
Yeah, they just found two bodies.
How many people have they lost?
I don't know what the total is.
They found two bodies, I saw.
Yeah. Like, in now? Like, after 2 months?
I imagine this whole place was underwater, huh?
Man, just amazing that anyone can survive.
So do y'all have like supplies being shipped from support directly to you guys?
Yeah, it's pretty difficult here though for just a number of reasons. Like we get it all from the States mainly, but we're trying to be more like self-sufficient now that, so now that the supermarket's open and there's a farm about 15 minutes in the other direction from the airport, we're trying to use more like local produce and
local economy.
We're kind of relying on another organization for food.
So we just did a big loop, right?
It's a little bit.
get them back. Put them back on their feet. Take you walk through the grounds.
Basically, once you see
those roads that go down. Rice? I talked to my mom today. Like solar panels. A bit cloudy today. Not too bad. It's a work trailer. Where's this? Power. Big gas. This is the shower. The tree is uprooted. This is Greg's play-by-play. Fun those are. Imagine this was all underwater. As you can see, the debris. Of course, it could have been like this before. Children's playground. It's now wood. Let's go eat some supper.
This is the point we need.
Okay. Straight ahead, huh? Close. Puppy. He's just chilling. So here we are in Hope Town Village. It's the local police station. Some stuff to do here for sure. Two to five. Sunday, so everybody's at church. And they'll come out and start drinking. I bet this is just cute. It's not all destroyed. What do you do with it all? Here at the edge of Hope Town. makes you very thankful. Just in a moment, everything like that could just be blown away. One day you're living in paradise, and the next day you're sitting under the wrath, the prince of the power of the air. That which gives life can also take. Looking good, what do you guys think?
Man.
He's hopped up across the council.
I don't want to tell you.
I gotta see if you look
like November.
Nice. No, I like it. I think I look good. I don't know what I look like, but I look good.
You look good too.
I look good.
Look that way?
And it's gonna become a thing.
Okay, look at this one.
I think you should
go
like half under the chin. The chin. Bring half of the chin with the way.
Concrete studs pushed over. 220 miles an hour of wind will do. Walking down the road to Abaco. Who I got with me?
Got Alex.
Alex. Alex, where are you from, Alex?
From the UK. And
UK.
We're coming over to Abaco to lend our helping hand as much as we can for the week.
Very nice.
Hi.
What's your story?
I'm Kate.
Kate.
I'm with Alex.
Yeah, there we go, right?
Helping out.
Doing what we can.
Sailors on the sea.
That's it.
Putting your feet on the land. Yeah. To rebuild.
Time is still a beautiful world.
That's it. Beautiful country. Decimated. Cool glass. That was a dangerous place to be in a storm.
Yeah, we're going there right now.
Reminds me of The Walking Dead.
Yeah, I'll see that.
Bargain sale. Yeah. We lost. There's a split unit. Let's get that thing going. Here's what we got to pick up. Probably like this before we got here. Run away. Lots of work to do. We need everybody's help. Here helping out with the World Food Program, loading up some trucks. You can see the port got hit pretty good. It's a fixer-upper for sure. Bomb went off. No. Well, I can if you want. You got a story to tell? This is Luis from Bolivia.
Bolivia.
What organization are you with, Luis?
The World Food Program.
World Food Program. He's here in the Bahamas, helping out for Africa. Unless you want to say something, do you have something you want to say?
Well, nothing that we've been...
So what you guys doing here?
Yeah, we are... supporting all the logistics on the island with sea and land transport and also storage for all the humanitarian partners.
Okay.
And besides that, we're also implementing a cash-based transfer program in the island.
How long have you guys been here?
Since the first day. Even before.
Oh, yeah.
We arrived on the 31st of August in the island, before the hurricane.
Oh, right. getting here ready for it, huh? Yeah. You were here during the hurricane?
No.
No? Oh.
And then we got Amanda.
Amanda.
And Abby.
Yeah, there's a lot to do for sure.
Yeah, this is going to take a while.
Are you safe?
Special delivery.
$1.8 million dishes served. That's where it all goes down.